The killings occurred during a robust police campaign dubbed Operation Restore Confidence, a crackdown on a spate of gangland-style shootings that had instilled fear in the populace and gave the impression that criminals were able to operate with impunity. Although Operation Restore Confidence seemed to attract widespread public support, there were concerns that it were merely a cover for extrajudicial police killings, concerns shared by human rights attorney Mary Francis, who is happy that the team of Jamaican law enforcers is here to investigate the matter.
We heard so many allegations as to what happened during that period, Operation Restore Confidence. And I think only an independent investigation will bring the truth to light as to how those men lost their lives, who was involved, whether they had higher powers, gave instructions to the police guard and so forth. All those things could be determined by this investigation. And also the fact that the original counterparts, the CARICOM appointed team, is good because we don't have an external body actually coming in to do the investigation.
During one single incident in May 2011, police fatally shot 5 criminal suspects. Attorney Mary Francis believes members of the team that's here to investigate the police slayings are professional and persons of integrity. She is hoping that at the end of their probe, their findings will resolve the issues surrounding the police actions and ensure that the surviving relatives of those who lost their lives during Operation Restore Confidence would get justice.
You know, the inquests that were held so far, I hear a lot of talk about, oh, there were inquests and the police were absolved. What type of inquest? It was a one-sided affair. Most of the family members never attended. They didn't even know when those inquests would be there. Some of them don't even know the verdicts. When the verdicts were arrived at. So you cannot say that this was a comprehensive inquiry into what took place. Up to now, you have the inquest of the Beaufort 5 still outstanding because they're waiting for forensics, ballistic expert to test guns and so forth. It opened in 2011, that inquest began. So if you have an inquest stretching over such a long period of time, the evidence will be compromised, the jurors will get fed up and so on.
According to Ms. Francis, the Coroner's Act should be reformed to ensure that it meets the requirements of a good justice system and the rule of law. For the DBS News World, Alex Bousquet reporting.